Phelps, Bukowski, you have a new case. Two women, possible drink drive.
How is that a case?
The broad says she was doped and that somebody tried to kill her.
Where did this take place?
That's the bit you're gonna love. Right across the street.
What?
A Chevy Styline took a nosedive off the escarpment, fetched up underneath a Cola King billboard. Up to it, boys. We got bad guys to catch.
Up to it. Let's do it.
I'm telling you.
Yeah, rhymes. Right. So our main thing this time.
Try not to work too hard.
Oh, we won't be. Well, they won't be, I imagine. So our main objective in this case is to try and do a bit better than we did in the last fucking case. Because the thing I learned about the last case, the thing I learned about this game in the last case, was that the words truth, doubt, and lie are not as simple as you may first think. You know, someone may tell the truth, but you want more out of them, so you doubt them, which is weird, because, like, you know, it's not that they're necessarily lying, it's just you think there's more to it, which to me doesn't seem like the truth, that's just like pushing for more evidence, but whatever. It's almost like whether they're helping you out by telling you the truth. So it's almost whether they're helping you, whether they're withholding something, or whether they're flat out not telling
you
something.
Stop just ahead.
It's essentially what you gotta kind of aim for. Whether it's true or not is kind of relevant, but either way, let's see if we can do better on this one.
Her face looks familiar.
Well, that's June Ballard. Tarzan's sister, Beast of the Amazon. She's married to Guy McAfee. The captain has moved to Vegas now, but the two of them still have juice.
Okay, so movie star.
Traffic.
Detective Phelps. Hey, Bukowski. Long time no see.
You could have called this in by megaphone, Enrique. Phelps, this is Enrique Gonzalez. Enrique was a pretty decent middleweight. What do we have, Gonzalez?
Broad drives right through the empty lot and off the side of the escarpment. Her story is that a movie producer doped her and her friend and sent the car over the cliff.
Was anyone hurt?
Driver's beat up. Not too bad, considering. If she hadn't hit that billboard, we'd be scraping both of them off the pavement. Passengers are Jessica Hamilton. She's just a kid. She's pretty knocked around.
Kid gonna be all right?
I think so. They've taken her to central receiving. If you want to take a look around, you can stall the ambulance.
Thanks. Do that.
One more thing. Watch out for the driver. She cuts rough.
Okay.
If you're looking for the coroner, he's down by the crash site.
Okay, let's go down to the crash site. As I've said many times, I want to get all the evidence before I speak to anyone. But, assuming this is the right way, actually. And there's the office, look. Look at it being all, majestic. Majestic, what am I talking about? Right, there's coroner.
You'll want to see this, Phelps. There, laid out on the trunk. And that isn't even the best part.
Let's have a look. Okay. Underwear.
They've been torn off.
Do, do, do,
where did
do,
you find
do, 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 do.
They were stuffed in the young lady's handbag. I'll run a trace for semen when I get back to the lab.
Oh, okay. That took a sudden turn. What we got here? A letter. Jessica Hamilton's the passenger, isn't she? So it's obviously her. Please, please, dear, come home. If you're worried about your father, yada yada. So it looks like, yeah, letter from her mother. Okay. Fair enough. That's probably a way from there, I think. Let's have a look at the front. Oh, hell. She hit her head pretty hard.
Looks like they're lucky they weren't more badly injured.
Must have been unconscious. Being relaxed tends to lessen the soft tissue damage.
So be unconscious. Okay. Why would they be unconscious? Both of them? What's this? It's a number plate. Look at it being all number platey. I mean, there's not much about that, really, is there? So chat with...
Drunk driver?
Your friend?
Not. How so?
Well, a head I found without a body piqued my interest. See what you think.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio.
Is it cool, real? That was terrible. That was terrible.
No. I think it's supposed to be a replica of an Indian shrunken head. It's some kind of curio or movie prop. See the casting marks? What's it made from?
Okay.
Plaster of Paris would be my first guess, then paint it.
So we can rule out the murder angle?
No, you can rule that in. That thing was wedging the accelerator to the floor. Whoever did it wanted these women dead.
Hmm. Okay.
How does someone manage to tip their ride straight off a cliff? If the driver's in a fit state, we should ask.
Let's go and speak to her. So, someone's wedged a prop head under the... But who would use a prop head, you know? Like, it seems that's such an easy thing to trace. As opposed to, like, a brick or a bit of wood or something, you know. Like, why use something which you could trace? Something doesn't smell right to me.
Mrs. McAfee, we would like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
I prefer to use my maiden name, June Ballard. You might be familiar with some of my work.
Can you tell us what happened here?
You're kind of cute for a cop. Maybe a bit on the serious side.
What about me, June? I'm a big fan of
you?
Beast of...
I don't like. Keep out of
this. Haha! Suck it. Okay.
We understand that you're still suffering from the effects of the accident, Mrs. McAfee. The officer says that you claimed that you were drugged. Who did this to you?
That rat slipped us a Mickey Finn. No wonder I feel so dopey. I can't remember.
Doubt?
It's a serious offense to withhold information from the police during a criminal investigation.
Get out of the way, photographer.
I told you to call me June. You're making me feel like an old lady. And don't bother your handsome head about this. My husband will settle the score with Mark Bishop.
Probably shouldn't have said that.
What can you tell us about the passenger in your car?
Jessica Hamilton. Poor Jessica. It's been a rough day for her. She's desperate to break into movies. What more can I say?
I think you're lying, Mrs. McAfee. I think something happened to Jessica yesterday before the crash.
Ah, there we go.
I'm offended, Sunshine. Do you have any proof?
Well, that we can... Okay, that's just... Yeah, that's the underwear, right?
Miss Hamilton's underwear was physically torn from her body.
She wanted to go to a casting. I took her to a casting. Whatever happened after that is between her and Mark Bishop.
Okay.
We found a shrunken head. It was used to tamper with your car.
You see, I normally don't drive off cliffs. The last thing I remember is getting behind the wheel.
Doubt.
It's obviously some kind of movie prop. You must know where it came from.
In case you hadn't noticed, I am the talent. And the talent doesn't deal with props or sets or any of that kind of stuff. Why don't you ask Mark Bishop which prop house he uses?
Okay, she seems to be pushing Mark Bishop quite a lot, so maybe let's ask her about
Mark Bishop.
Yes, she did.
Might have had something to do with this.
He's a movie producer. As for his involvement, you just leave it to me and my husband to worry about.
Doubt, I guess.
I want to know what happened to you two that made him want to commit a double murder.
Bishop offered me a part in his picture. Then he withdrew it. Fact is, we had a deal. I pressed him on it. And this is where I end up.
Mrs. McAfee, I think it would be in everyone's best interest if you accompanied Patrolman Gonzalez back to the receiving hospital.
I'm going to be okay. These guys can take me home after my lawyer and I have talked to the news house.
Mrs. McAfee, you are still under the influence of narcotics, and you're likely to go into shock once the drugs wear off.
And I thought you were a heel. It's nice of you to be concerned.
I
think we're good here. Let's go see what we can shake out of the kid.
Right, okay. Let's go and interview Jessica Hamilton at Central Receiving Hospital. So that's over there, right? Monsieur? Let's drive, seeing as it's probably just over here.
KTPL to car 11K, 11 King. The car crash victim has regained consciousness. consciousness and sent to receiving hospital.
11K Roger, en route.
Yeah. Should drive more often. I'm damn good at it. But, you know, it's only a short trip, so... Oh, there we go. Okay. So it's a okay. It's the hostel inside central receiving. Fair enough.
Hello, Detective Phelps. Here to interview a Jessica Hamilton.
Jessica Hamilton. Oh yes, she's in the room right behind you, Detective.
She's into it, Snyder. No,
I don't. Feeling better since this morning, Jessica?
A little. My head still feels swimmy.
How young is she? Jesus.
Hello, Jessica. My name is Cole Phelps. I'm a policeman. I'd like to talk to you about your accident, if that's okay.
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 Can you tell me what you remember about the crash?
It's all kind of fuzzy. I remember waking up here. Nothing happened yesterday.
Okay, right. Lie.
Tell the truth, Jessica. Why the big cover-up?
I'm not lying to you.
Well, that process is a lot.
Your underwear and your handbag, Jessica. You need to tell us what happened.
That's twice they said something about her underwear being in her handbag torn off her, and I've said yeah. That's yeah because I got it right, not yeah because that happened, by the way.
To be in movies. I told Junie what happened, and she told me to toughen up. That was the price of stardom.
Did she now, cold-hearted bitch?
It's not Junie's fault. It's not my first time. I had a boyfriend back home, but my father found out about him.
Even if you consented, Jessica, you're still underage.
Okay, yeah, good point.
We need to get in touch with your parents, Jessica, to tell them what has happened.
Oh, you don't need to worry them. They sent me along to stay with Aunt June. They trust her to take care of me.
Another lie, is it?
You're lying, Jessica. How are we going to make this right if you lie to us?
Please, Detective, why would I lie to you?
The letter! What's that? Medical examination of Jessica, I've been criminally abused. Okay, hell. Didn't know that was in there.
Because you're a runaway.
Oh, what a roller this one.
Don't have your parents' permission.
Back to form after our last bad case.
I went with Junie to this strange place. It's difficult to remember. Someone gave me a drink to calm my nerves, and then I felt faint. I think I must have passed out.
Okay.
How did you meet Mr. Bishop?
Well, Junie is a big movie star. You probably know that. She's doing a new movie.
Is that right? I don't know. Let's use intuition. Okay. Truth?
What do you know about Bishop?
Okay.
He makes movies. I had to do a screen test. That's when you say some lines in front of a camera with the lights turned on you.
Well, screwed that up. Still one, hopefully
that's bad. To you, Jessica. Where exactly did it take place?
Please, it's scary. It's really difficult to think of anything.
Jessica.
Yeah.
I really need you to help me here.
I remember the mermaid.
Was the mermaid in the movie too?
No, it was on the front of a building. We pulled up in front of the mermaid.
Thank you, Jessica. You've been a big help. Here's my
card. One bad there. That's not too bad. So that's all right.
Just get in touch, okay?
Okay.
I think it might be a good idea if you went back home till you felt better, Jessica.
I couldn't do that, officer. What if I got the part and I wasn't there?
Well...
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that?
Must be her lawyer. He certainly expedited her release.
I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry?
We should follow her.
Dramatic music!
There she goes. Come on.
Right. Let's chase her. Ah, it's not one of these, though. Not an actual chase, just a... stay far enough away kind of job. Okay.
Ballard is definitely up to something.
Well, I would agree with you there. I don't really trust her.
Too close, Phelps. You're way too close.
Yeah, I really don't trust her, so...
she seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery.
Yeah. Maybe she's the one who put the shrunken head under there. And she's trying to frame our bishop. Ah, now we're onto something.
You've got a pretty funny idea what keeping a low profile means, Phelps.
Kind of need to move. There we go. Yeah, we didn't really kind of smash the front of our car in a little bit there, but it's alright. God. Okay, she's stopping. Where is she stopping? That window just miraculously appeared. What's going on?
Get in there and see what she's up to.
Okie dokie. She was in here, wasn't it? Yes, it was. Tyler Booth and newspaper.
I can't decide between the tuna fish and the chicken.
No, I don't want him taught a lesson. You know what I want.
I'm trying to listen to the...
Well, then make someone else do it. You still know people out here, don't you? Then make some calls.
Can't really make it out properly.
I'm going to be very clear about this. You get this done, or I'm... Wilson's Hotel. Mr. Mark Bishop, that son of a bitch, lives in apartment 803.
Okay.
Sure, I got the film.
Okay. Well, that's something. We know where Mark Bishop lives. Question is... yeah, I guess we're going to have to go to his apartment because that's the only thing we can do, right? Okay, then. Fine.
What's the story? I'm guessing she didn't stop for light refreshments.
She made a call. Sounds like Mark Bishop has a heap of trouble here. I've got an address. Wilson's Hotel, apartment 803.
Oh, shit. You better step on it.
If he's got any sense, he'll be as far away from home as possible.
Get the siren on.
If he had sense, he wouldn't have tried bumping off Guy McCaffrey's wife in the first place. Or he'd done the job properly. McCaffrey will break a fella's legs just for looking at the ball.
What did you make of the kid? Did you believe her story?
I
think she was doped out of her tiny mind and given the casting couch.
The hell?
That fucking bitch Ballard sold her out.
Okay.
So Ballard was doing something.
Can't really J-turn very easily in these things.
Why did they try to kill her?
Oh god, how do you get out of this place? Should let him drive.
All units in the vicinity in car 11K, 11 King, a 415 in progress at apartment 803, Wilson's Apartment Hotel.
That's the one.
20 West 7th Street, Westlake Park. 11
hey, it's got a landmark.
All other units go to. KGPL clear.
That's our guy.
Let's get to the apartment before someone gets hurt.
Okay, try and look at the mini-map at the same time. It's not easy. Watch the traffic, work out which road to take, and check the mini-map. Oh god, out of the way, you bastards. Come on. Can you hear the siren? I guess straight on, and then right. Yeah! There we go, here we are, here we are. Is that left here, I guess? Yeah. Okay, in we go. Run, man, run!
I'm Detective Phelps. We received a call about a domestic disturbance in apartment 803.
Oh, the detectives. Listen, Mrs. Bishop's pretty upset. Take the elevator and then left down the corridor. It's the last door on the right.
Okie dokie. Okie doke.
Sounds like we're about to make it a hat trick of hysterical female witnesses.
Yeah, that might well be the case, buddy. You say left, then this last door on the right? Yeah, it looks like that one, right? Yeah.
LAPD, ma'am. Are you in danger?
I'm all right now. You just missed them. Horrible, awful men.
Are you injured, Mrs.?
Mrs. Bishop. Gloria Bishop. Please, come in, officers. I'll just need to sit down for a moment. Forgive me.
That's perfectly normal, ma'am.
Just look at this mess!
We'll take a quick search of the premises, ma'am. You take a moment to gather your thoughts.
Okie doke. So, search the room, speak to the woman. That's the thing, the standard kind of way that this game plays out.
Mystical.
Okay. Trying to avoid the things we clearly aren't anything to do with anything. Maybe the ring?
Incidental.
Nope. Is that lipstick?
Nope.
Probably not. And a hairbrush.
Junk.
Junk. Exactly. Well, we're trying. Ah, that looks like something.
What do you have to do to earn $20,000?
$20,000 check, okay. Is that anything?
Doesn't tell me anything.
It does not, you're right. Let's carry on searching, I reckon that was in there. Gay cowboys to Mark Bishop with things from silver screen props. Silver screen props, that might be our place to check out. Might be the place with the mermaid even. It's hard to work out. That looks like something.
Great Wall of Babylon. A replica of a replica.
Okay.
It's like the old movie set downtown.
Yeah. Okay. Hard to tell what's actually going to give you a clue and what isn't. What that note? What about in here? Spoons, crap like that, I reckon. That clock's clearly something to pick up, isn't it? Well, I'm going to pick up something, I guess. No! Don't be so ridiculous, you ridiculous person! The phone, no. That statue, no. Talk to her yet.
It's like we found our mermaid.
Ah,
with
yeah.
These men in the picture.
They work together on occasion. That's Hopkins' shop.
Okay. Yeah. Let's have a chat with her.
Those men, I think they work for Guy McAfee. Do you know the name?
No. Why should I?
June Ballard is married to Guy McAfee. Have you heard of her?
That slut. She's been badgering my husband for days.
Mrs. McAfee alleges that your husband tried to kill her and her friend last night. I think you should tell us what you know.
My husband's a movie producer. This has something to do with his new picture. He doesn't include me in his business.
Doubt?
June Ballard said she had a deal to be in his new picture.
Mark repeatedly told her no. He had Joan Leslie lined up for the role. That's how he got the finance. June made all kinds of threats. She was very rude to me.
You know June Ballard?
We were both on the same picture a few years back. That's how I met my husband.
Okay, a lot more questions now. Okay,
where
about
Where can we find your husband, ma'am?
He told me he would be on set. That's all I know.
Either we find him, or McAfee's people do, Mrs. Bishop.
Yeah, I trust
you. If you care for him, you should make sure that we find him first.
I do care for him. But I don't really know where he'd go if he were in trouble. Hopgood might know.
Okay. Why is your husband paying Lorna Hopgood $20,000?
Lorna? Marlon's ex-wife? Are you sure?
Well, lie, I guess we have the evidence, right?
You're lying, Mrs. Bishop. It's some kind of payoff. You know exactly what the money is for and who it's getting paid to.
Do I? Would you like to prove that, detective?
Yes, I would. With a big old check for 20 grand.
Your husband looks like he's being blackmailed. They obviously have something on him if he's prepared to kill to cover it up. Why is the payment going to Hopgood and not McAfee?
Lorna works at a check-cashing place in Hollywood. You need to ask Hopgood why he needs that much money in cash.
Your husband was at a casting yesterday with a young girl?
Not that I know of. He told me he was looking at locations. The picture's been cast.
It's not going to be a doubt or a lie, isn't it? But okay, there we go.
Jessica remembered a mermaid. The mermaid on the front of the prop store. You better come clean with me.
This is a sick town, detective. Are you sure you really want to know? The truth is, my husband likes them young.
Oof. And you think that's okay?
I was 16 when I first met him. I thought he was a genius, a magician with film. I was 20 before I realized he was just a B-movie hack. But he's nothing compared to some of the monsters at these big studios. My guess is Ballard sacrificed her little friend. Happens to a lot of girls.
Okay.
Your husband is in trouble. It could go easier for him if you were more helpful, Mrs. Bishop.
He's a big boy, detective, and so are you. This is Hollywood. There's always a deal to be done.